Bonsoir, good evening, shalom. First, please accept my regrets for being unable to join with you tonight in person as you celebrate our friend, the Minister of State of Foreign Affairs, the Honorable Peter Kent. Let me just say what a great job Peter has been doing for you, both at home as an MP in the House of Commons and abroad as a minister for our great country. Peter brings an unwavering personal commitment to the most fundamental values of our government, indeed of our country, freedom, democracy, and justice. Supporting these principles is not an option. It is not an option for Peter Kent. It is not an option for this government. And I know it is not an option for the members of Chabad at Flamingo. It is a solemn duty to support these ideals, and it is a duty that we embrace as the government of Canada and as citizens of our great country. We do so not for recognition or reward, but because it is the right thing to do. And consistent with those values, Peter truly personifies the support and friendship that this government has given to the Middle East's only true functioning democracy, the State of Israel. So my friends, it is more than fitting that you choose to honor Peter this evening. You will find no stronger proponent of the fundamental principles that we share than Peter Kent. I'm proud and fortunate to have him in my cabinet, and I know you are equally proud to have him as your Member of Parliament. Congratulations on a wonderful evening, a wonderful gala, and I look forward to seeing you in person again and soon. Toda raba.
Peter Kent was born in a Canadian Army hospital in Sussex, England, on July 27, 1943, in the midst of the raging inferno that was the Second World War. His father, Parker, served as an officer with the Edmonton Regiment. In 1966, he recorded history for the first time when he journeyed to Southeast Asia as a freelance foreign correspondent to cover the Vietnam War.
Three rockets have hit in this area in the last 5 minutes, killing two children. The impact that it has had on this house and the damage that it's done to these bodies is something that's very difficult to put into words. The pictures have to speak for themselves.
Posted to Europe, he first visited Israel in the fall of 1973, covering the Yom Kippur War.
Israeli soldiers are not enthusiastic about expressing opinions on the way this war has gone. Their surface solidarity with all superior decisions is unshakable.
It was then that his decades-old relationship with the land and the people of Israel blossomed.
In Israel during the Yom Kippur War, it was a democratic society like Canada's, although very different than Canada's, under attack by totalitarian states that surrounded Israel. And I learned just how fragile and precarious the existence of the State of Israel actually is.
That relationship continued to flower over dozens of visits to the Holy Land, forging and solidifying his steadfast devotion to Israel and the Jewish community.
That's unbelievable. Like, that's unprecedented. I don't believe there's another member on the Hill who's been to Israel so many times.
I think it all comes down to a matter of principle, to recognize Israel's right not only to defend itself, but to speak up and to defend the very concept of a Jewish state and its right to exist in peace in the Middle East.
In 2008, he was elected Member of Parliament for the Thornhill riding. He was appointed to cabinet and assigned duty by Prime Minister Harper as Minister of State of Foreign Affairs for the Americas. It is the Canadian government which represents Israel's interests in Cuba and in Venezuela, where the Israeli embassy was closed by the Chavez government in 2009 during Israel's defensive incursion into Gaza.
The government of the day has not been particularly hospitable and has used some of the ancient forms, the historic forms of intimidation and finger pointing and blame shifting whenever anything goes wrong. But it's a very dynamic community, and it's a community that appreciates Canada speaking up in its interests.
Le estaremos de por vida agradecido. El mensaje de nuestra comunidad judía para el señor Ken de gratitud, que Dios le dé larga vida para que siga luchando y colaborando por el pueblo judío que tanto lo estima.
When faced by those who seek to wipe both it and the Jewish people from the face of the earth, Israel can always count on our unequivocal support.
Here we have a genuine friend. Here we have a government that has taken a stand even when it hasn't been politically expedient. I don't think Israel has another friend in the world the way it has found a friend in Canada. May God bless those who have blessed our people. May God look after those who have looked after our people, and we hope that together, as Canadians, we will share a great deal of good news and good times in the future.
He's a member of the Canadian Broadcast Hall of Fame, recipient of the President's Award from the Radio Television News Directors Association of Canada, and a four-time Emmy nominee. In an interview published February 12, 2010 in an Israeli magazine, he said, "An attack on Israel would be considered an attack on Canada." His words paraphrase Prime Minister Harper's frequent statement that a threat to Israel is a threat to Canada. Ladies and gentlemen, Chabad at Flamingo is proud to be honoring this exceptional human being and true friend of our community, Mr. Peter Kent.